every time I come to an education institute like this, I really feel overwhelmed. So only because I'm still not a graduate. I'm still studying, and hopefully I will be a graduate soon, and I'll be a PAR. But yeah, so while coming here, I almost missed my flight, and trust me, it wasn't my fault. I was there 2 hours prior, and I got this crazy cold, and I'm still getting my voice back. But I'm still here, and everything did not go wrong. So, you know, when I think of Murphy's Law, what I understand from it is that it gives you the possibility to think that, okay, this may go wrong, and that may go wrong. But how I understand Murphy's Law is that it gives me the chance to choose to know what is going to go wrong so that I can correct it. I'll give you an example. When I decided to follow my dreams and audition for Miss India, just 2 nights before the audition in Delhi, and yeah, I go all set and everything, pack my bags. I have no idea about anything regarding pageants. The only experience I had was a little bit of ramp walking the camera because I used to model. But other than that, I mean, I had no experience, and trust me, the ramp walk and the camera was hardly anything when it comes to pageants. So I went there, I saw the girls. They were all so beautiful, smart, and talented that I felt like going back. I said to myself, this is not going to happen, just pack your bags and go, because you don't know anything, you don't know how to even put proper makeup on your skin, just leave. But obviously, I didn't take that option. I stood there, and I thought, you know, if I don't make it, what is the possible reason why I'm not going to make it? Maybe I'm going to walk really funny, in a funny way, or I'm going to say something very stupid. So these are the two things. The first round was how to walk, and the second round was how you talk, how you introduce yourself. So in the first round, I made sure, before the first round, I went to every corner, and I was just walking around. And all the girls probably thought I was crazy, but that's all I wanted to do. I wanted to correct myself. I wanted to walk confidently so that nothing goes wrong. So yeah, I passed the first round, and then comes the second round, where I have to introduce myself. Whenever I found a mirror around me, I would just go and, hi, I'm Priyadarshini Chatterjee, 19 years old, blah, blah, blah. And everybody was like, what is this girl doing? I was just talking to the mirror. But yeah, I did that, and I nailed it again. So that's how I got through Miss India. But one thing was in my mind that I have these scars. I have 35 external stitches and 28 internal stitches, which I'll come to later. But, you know, I actually thought that these scars and the burn marks I have, it's probably not going to allow me to contest or be a part of this pageant. But later I realized that it's nothing. I just learned to wear this as a badge of pride. Then came this point when, you know, at times you take responsibilities for what you do. You can't always blame fate that, you know, this didn't happen because it wasn't meant to be, or it didn't happen because it was just not supposed to happen. At times, it's also your fault why certain things don't happen. And you want to take responsibilities for that. The only thing is, you learn from your mistake, and you make sure you do not repeat it again. So, for example, again, I went for Miss World, and I got placed as well among 20 other countries. And I got an award for Beauty for the Purpose as well. But I didn't win the crown, you know. The crown wasn't meant to be mine, probably. That was not the end of my world. That was the end of Miss World for me. But my world had just started. And I had so much to learn from it. And today when I know that the mistakes that I had done then, probably taking things for granted, or you know, not making full use of the opportunities that you get. So now when I do my things on a regular basis, I make sure that I do not make those mistakes again. So yes, that's how I learned to actually defy Murphy's Law all the time. Everything did not go wrong. But you know, at times, certain things do go wrong and you have nothing to do with it. And you just realize that you break down, you know. You break down and you feel everything is falling apart. You don't have anything to do. So that point, I came to a point in life where I was born as a premature baby, and the doctor said I wouldn't survive, but I survived. And then I used to visit the hospital once in every year at least, till I was 9 years old. At 9, I got this major stomach problem, this pain I used to get. I was hospitalized, and the doctor said, we don't know what's wrong with you, we are going to take you to the hospital, and then we are going to operate, and then you are going to see what's going on. And then my dad's like, my dad's furious, you know. He's like, are you mad? She's my daughter, you can't just take her to the operation theater and then decide what you are going to do with her. So, but then they did diagnose this appendix minor issue that I have, and also this tumor that I had on my intestine. So they removed all of that, and I was safe. Again, at 15, I got another attack. And then again, the doctor said that, you know, we have to do another surgery because I was diagnosed with intestinal strictures. So, which means that your intestines, my intestine was thin and thick in certain places. So I had to get it removed. A part of my intestine had to get removed. So again, the doctors were really, you know, not so sure. Obviously, my parents didn't tell me, but I could feel it in their voices. I could feel it around that something was not right, you know, something was not right. And all I wanted to do at that point of time was get out of the operation theater and survive only for my parents. Because I saw in their eyes, I saw the hope that they had that, you know, just leave everything aside, you got to come back, and I have to come back. And probably because the faith they had in me and the faith that I had in myself and in my life and in humanity probably is the reason why I'm standing here today. So learning from all of these things, I've learned that, you know, life is going to take you to so many places, it's going to take you to so many turns, but you have to realize what gives you happiness. Now for me, I do a lot of things that makes me happy. I teach in my school, I do modeling as a hobby, and today I'm here giving a TEDx talk. So, you know, these little things give me a lot of pleasure in life. And I always feel that you should follow your heart, and that's what life is all about, right? You should, at the end of the day, when it's your last day on earth, you should be able to pass away as a very happy person, and you've lived your life to the fullest. So, yes, that's pretty much all about how my journey has been through. And I hope that I can inspire more and be inspired throughout my life.